hi guys, and I'm back with a strength test, you know, to find out which one is my strongest 040s. Because the simple fact is, the other night I was thinking about my granddad and the time we used to spend at his house with the training sets, and he told me off for running the basic 040 that I had, which is basically like, which was in a video, like the number 9, I think it is, and the Eddie Stobart. And I rang it with some trying coaches, and I got told off because he moaned that the coaches were technically too heavy for this loco. So I got me thinking, is which one is my strongest one? My money, this is only my guess at the moment, my money is on this one, Dodo. For simple fact is, it's the more modernist one, and I've seen clips of it on social media pulling quite a bit of stock. The benchmark for the test will be a Bachmann 060 USA tank. So yeah, I will see you at the end of the video. Bye. So let's see how many coaches the 040s can pull. And we're using basically the railroad teak ones. We have 8 here, one being in BR Blood and Custard. And then we have, I believe, the Mark 1s. We have 10. So let's see how many it can pull. But first, we'll use this USA class, Southern USA class, as a benchmark. Because the simple fact is, it's a dock shunter, and they used to be able to pull full rate coaches from the ships, as it was. And yes, I know it's an 060, but this is going to be the benchmark, because this is what I'm basing it on. And it's the most modernist loco I have in my fleet. So here goes. So yeah, we have 8 coaches here on this USA tank. And they go all the way around to over there. 8 so far. Let's see if it can pull it. With ease, which is surprising, but maybe Batman got it right. So with ease, let the whole train come around once. So next up is add some more, really. I've got 2 left of these, and the next is teaks. And that was, the power on the controller wasn't even at midday. It's quite impressive, really. So yeah, here goes, let's add some more coaches. So now let's try it with 10. As you can see, if we just look over the top of the loco, that is where the train ends. There, that makes 10. So let's see if we can do it, shall we? With ease, not much power there either. So I've added 2 more coaches, which are teaks, and they're over there. And that makes it 12, I believe. some feet for a small engine like this. Surely by now it's got to struggle a little bit. All cleanly round. Looks like it goes out to some more coaches, and I'll get back to you when it starts to struggle really. So we are at 14 coaches now, and it's there. This is silly there, and I believe this is the limit. I may add one more to it, I don't know. I don't want to overdo the motor, stress it out, but no, that's it. I think that's it. We'll call it quits. 14 is the one to beat. So I'll bring on the 040s for you. And I do apologise if people find this boring. I'm sorry, it's just something different. So let's start with the Pug. This came out in the 2000s. The goal is the whole train has to get past that in the whole lap. So it goes around once and the whole train has to pass that to count. So we have 10 on here. Let's see what it can do. No, we're not going to do 10. I don't want to burn out the motor. So off camera, I did some testing to work out what it can do just. And basically, it's quite an impressive number. I didn't really want to bore you lot with going, oh well, I'll take this one off, I'll take that one off, etc, etc. I just want to get straight to the point. So this is a number, are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. You see, its limit is just 8. Off camera it made it round, but clearly it's not going to, so we'll call it 8. But it'd definitely do 7. 8 is its limit, which is not bad. So let's move on to the next victim. the next loco. So next loco is this 040. It's basically a railroad one. I had it from my first train set. And this is very basic. I thought I'd test it with the limit of the Pug. I think that's what I'm going to do, limit of the Pug. And see if it can cope with that. And yeah, so here it goes. Yeah, it can do 8. I think 8 is its limit. I would say 9 at a push, but I don't want to put any stress on the motor, so we call it 8. That was a fairly quick one. So let's move on to the next loco. So yeah, let's start with this really old girl. She's from the 60s and she's made by Triang. The heaviest 040 I believe I have. Let's see if we can manage all these coaches that I had from the previous train, which was the number 9 green one.
with ease, with ease.
So yeah, this is the end of the train there. It has reached the limit of the USA tank 14. Let's just see. No. So we've got all the way around there. 14. And this is an 040. It's the fastest limit. And then it uncouples. So 14 for the poly. So next up is this, well, 040 obviously. It's basically Smokey Joe with a different livery. This is the South Wales cardboard one. This is another Hornby loco. So for all the ones bar Polly, I've been Hornby. Let's see if we can pull Polly's Raker coach, shall we? No, but the man's dancing inside though. No, he ain't gonna pull that. So what I'll do is get down to what it can pull and then come back to you. So yeah, I've found its limit, which has surprised me, I must say, which is 10. So over there, as you can see, 10, it's just the maroon coaches. So yeah, we'll give it a lap and let you know what you think, shall we? So yeah, 10. 10. Astonishing, really. So yeah, we'll move on to the next loco. So the next loco, guys, is this, Smokey Joe. This one I got about 2000. Let's see if it can pull its, technically, its sister load. Just give it a helping hand. The crunch died on it, so. Yeah, if he's. That's 10, you can at least do 10. So yeah, guys, you might have seen the clip there of it doing 12 coaches. That wasn't its limit. I actually can't find its limit. That's the issue. As you see, it's here. Currently, we have 16 coaches on. And there's the other bit. I could use four-wheel coaches, but that doesn't really help my theory of this. As you see, I weighed them out at the side of the video. So I'll just show you, we can do 16 coaches. There you go, 16 coaches is limit. So yeah, next up in this test, we have this, obviously no for, I don't know why I keep saying that, Eddie Stobart one. This came out about 2005. Let's see if we can pull Joe's train. I don't like saying load, load sounds wrong. Joe's train. So here it goes. Let's even back it up. It backs it up. Clearly it's a no. So I'll go and find its limit and get back to you.
So yeah, guys, I found its limits and it's 6, which is surprising. So yeah, guys, the next loco up is this Great Western 101 class, a Holden, I believe it is. Railroad again. This one's number 104. And yeah, we'll do the usual, as you know by now. See if we can take the train that Eddie Stobart just took and take it from there, really. So here it goes. So yeah, I overshot that a bit. I'll add one more coach and see if it can do the one more coach. But clearly it can easily handle, well, 6. It struggles on this bend over here near the shed. But every loco has so far. So it could be a little bit raised. But we'll add another coach. So yeah, I've added that one more coach. It's over there in the station. You just see it there. So let's see if we can do 7, shall we? 7. Oh, make go that way first. 7. Yeah, just. So 7 is its maximum. And there it goes, struggling again the bend. So 7. Next loco. So next up is the Santa Express, which is more modern than the Holden in Great Western. Still a Holden loco, but it's a different livery. So let's see if it can beat the 7 that its sister laid down, technically. Looks like it can. Not quite. So I've taken 1 off, that leaves it 6. Let's see if it can do a lap now with 6, shall we? So yeah, next up is the Coleman's Holden version. Only difference is the rods are slightly, well, more like Thomas and then Percy, if you know what I mean. This one's from the 80s. So let's see if we can manage the 6 that the Santa pulled, shall we? So yeah, with a nice long skid there, I shall go and find its limit and I'll get back to you. So yeah, guys, I have found its limits. It was just adding 1, which makes it 7. So yeah, we'll give it a lap and a few other views and then we'll move on to the final loco. I wonder if you can guess it by now. So here it goes. So yeah, guys, the final loco, which is this Hornby Doodoo from 2016, weighs quite a bit compared to the rest. The only one that's slightly heavier than it is the Poly. So I'm expecting good things on this. So yeah, let's see if we can carry the load of the Coleman one. Wrong way, that was backwards. It looks like it can going forwards. That was pretty low, and it made it round. So as you know by now, I'll go and add a coach or two, and we'll see if it can beat the target, which I think 16, so here goes. So yeah, around its limit, it may be a bit too much for it, but I think it's its limit, which is 9, I do apologize about that car, 9, here it goes. That's what I mean, just this limit there. Gotta make it faster. Yeah, so turn 9 is its limit, let's bring it back round once. And we'll shut the power off. So yeah, 9 once, I will bring up the leaderboard, and then we'll have our, give my views and stuff. Alright guys, I'll see you in a bit. So yeah guys, this was the end of the video. The outcome of the results is quite surprising. So yeah, here's the leaderboard. I wasn't expecting that. So yeah, quite surprising. I will just stress, this is on my layout, which is I believe is 90% level, there's a little incline over in this far corner over here in the shed, over here somewhere. So yeah, obviously if Graham or Peter Shaw or Simon or even layout 123 were to do it, they'd probably get different results. Which would be different. Or even Sam's train, he has an incline on his carpet somewhere. So that's my results. Please let me know what you think of this. I must stress, none of the locos were hurt during filming. It may look it, but they weren't. They're all healthy. I do have another idea for a video like this, if you'd like to see it. But that means getting my track on my carpet. Basically, my freight locos, about 6-7 of them, pulling how much freight they can possibly pull, or coaches, depending on what you want me to do. Doing that around the carpet, but I'm not too sure. If you guys want it, obviously I'll do it, but for that, I don't know. At some point I might do another 0401 with freight. I might do a 060 tank locos, basically just showing them what they can pull coaches again, the same coaches that you saw. But anyway guys, this is the video, end of the video. I'd be interested to see what you make of it. But till next time guys, which will probably be Friday, because it's a regular thing. I will speak to you then. It's goodbye from them. It's goodbye from me. Bye.